Kimani Ichung'wah and vs Kindiki tensions escalate as factions jostle to replace Gachagua. Mtazamaji, who will replace Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua between Kimani Ichung'wah and Kithure Kindiki? Now, tensions escalate in the Mount Kenya region as there is a new political battle between Kikuyu Member of Parliament Kimani Ichung'wah versus Kithure Kindiki, the Interior Minister, concerning who will take the spot left by DP Rigathi Gachagua. Welcome to Triple M TV as I bring you these breaking and shocking news. And before I bring you the news, subscribe to this channel, comment, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell to receive more updates. 105A, a political cold war has erupted within the Kenya Kwanza administration following the tabling of impeachment proceedings against Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua. Two powerful factions have emerged, each pushing for their preferred candidate to replace Gachagua, who is facing mounting pressure from internal party divisions. The two camps are rallying behind Interior Cabinet Secretary Kithure Kindiki and National Assembly Majority Leader Kimani Ichung'wah, sparking a fierce contest for the second most powerful seat in the country. The faction backing Kindiki points to his long political career and leadership experience as reasons for his suitability. Supporters highlight his previous roles as the Interior CS, Senate Deputy Speaker, and Senate Majority Leader, arguing that he was the favored candidate during UDA's nominations in 2022, before Gachagua was chosen. They also believe his knowledge of security issues and parliamentary procedures will serve President William Ruto's administration well during these turbulent times. However, Kindiki faces allegations that his tenure as Interior CS saw the brutal suppression of youth protests during the Gen Z demonstrations, an issue his detractors insist must be addressed before he can ascend to higher office. Now, on the other side, Ichung'wah faction is making a strong case for the majority leader's candidacy. Citing political pragmatism, they argue that for Ruto to regain control of the critical Mount Kenya voting bloc, he needs a leader from Kiambu County, which boasts over 1 million votes compared to Tharaka Nithi's smaller base. According to his backers, Ichung'wah's leadership of the National Assembly has been effective, and also he represents a strong link to the voter-rich Kiambu region, positioning him as more strategic choice for the presidency's political survival. Meanwhile, amid the factional infighting, rumors have surfaced that President Ruto is contemplating an entirely different approach by appointing Prime Cabinet Secretary Musalia Mudavadi to the position. Ruto reportedly views Mudavadi as a safe pair of hands with minimal political ambition, making him an easier deputy to manage. Adding to the drama are reports opposition leader Raila Odinga's camp has also thrown Homa Bay Governor Gladys Wanga's name into the ring, arguing that ODM deserves the seat for helping stabilize Ruto's administration. With both internal and external pressures building, the battle over Gachagua's replacement is quickly turning into a high-stakes contest that could reshape Kenya's political landscape. Member of Parliament Ndindi Nyoro also first to hound DP Rigathi Gachagua as he goes quiet over the motion, the impeachment motion, and as his name was missing from the list that appended the signatures for the impeachment motion. For a long time in Mount Kenya, Nyoro was largely perceived as Gachagua's political arch nemesis. Now, though silent and currently out of the country, Mr. Nyoro's name is among those said to be in the running for DP should the plot against Mr. Gachagua succeed. The Kiharu Member of Parliament, Samson Ndindi Nyoro, aged 38, was the first to start lighting fires under the seat of Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua before he suddenly went silent. This was long before troubles dimmed for Mr. Gachagua, who is 58 years, who now faces a motion to oust him as Deputy President. For a long time in Mount Kenya, Mr. Nyoro was largely perceived as Mr. Gachagua's political arch nemesis. Even now, there is speculation from State House mandarins that he might be part of President William Ruto's equation should Mr. Gachagua be deposed. Though silent and currently out of the country, Mr. Nyoro's name is among those said to be in the running for deputy president should the plot against Mr. Gachagua succeed. Mr. Nyoro went silent after the Gen Z protests commenced on June 25, 2024, which later led to the formation of the current broad-based government. By President Ruto, seen as a tactical silence since Mount Kenya started sulking immediately, Mr. Raila Odinga's men were brought into government. It was not lost to pundits that Mr. Nyoro had previously opposed the National Dialogue Committee. That was seen as a prelude to the rapprochement between Mr. President Ruto and Mr. Odinga. The Kiharu Member of Parliament has so far remained guarded regarding the appointment of Mr. Odinga's allies into cabinet, which the Gen Z protest as well as about political upheavals currently swirling around the deputy president. Kindly subscribe, comment, and do not forget to turn on the notification bell to receive more updates from Triple M TV, your favorite and your number one online news channel. Na mtazamaji, hizi ndo habari ambazo nimeweza kuzipokea hivi sasa, na zingine ambazo nitakuletea hapo baadaye. Endelea kutune in kwa hii channel, usisahau kufinya hiyo kidude ya subscription button ndio uweze kupokea hizi habari pindi ninapozipata. Welcome once again.